will convene shortly to review the latest weather and wind trends around the flight path of the rocket and make a decision about proceeding. Now, if all is go, we will be tracking a 4:33 p.m. Eastern launch for the return of human spaceflight to the International Space Station from U.S. soil.
Oh, here they are.
Here they come. NASA astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley. They've each made this journey twice before for the space shuttle missions, but they've never done this in a SpaceX spacesuit. They've never done this together, and they've never done this on their way to head to a commercially built rocket and spacecraft to head to space.
Marie, I was looking for that Astro van, and I see these white Teslas with meatballs and worms on them. It's just a new era in space travel.
Yesterday, they tweeted out a photo. That was so cool.
I saw that picture, and it had a prominent worm in the picture, right?
Yes.
Telling you, warm all day.
It's super hot, super muggy. So how are they staying cool?
There are these portable cooling units. We had one at the ONC building, two at the ONC building. There are two in the Teslas. There will be two in the elevators, and then two in the White Room. Their families, this is awesome.
Yeah, it's awesome that their families get to come up to the window and obviously get a little closer than everybody else.
There's Megan and her son. Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
These are precious moments. This is where what it's all about, as I mentioned before. It's about the people. It's about the families and working together. There they go.
Now, as we see the convoy begin the journey to the pad, 39A, we are thinking about each and every one of you, our colleagues and friends at SpaceX and NASA, who have had a hand in seeing the Crew Dragon commercial crew program come to life.
And we wish every single one of you could be here up close to see this, but we want you to be a part of this journey regardless of where you are watching today. And so for the next few minutes, while they're making their way to the pad, once NASA certifies the SpaceX systems for regular crew flights.
And right now, and you know, it's a really beautiful, you think about STEM education, but this is totally STEAM, science, technology, engineering, arts and mathematics. And I think, you know, SpaceX has done an incredible job of making things look really beautiful and functional, and you know, everything just fits perfectly.
END, ISS bound.
Oh,
you
nice.
Follow?
Nice.
Yeah. And hopefully they will be today. We just need the weather to say, I mean, it looks pretty nice right now, right?
But foam around the astronaut's body so that there's not any pressure points, and it's just generally a pleasurable journey to space. Dragon is a spaceship that's all about safety and reliability. We designed it to be two fault tolerant, which means that any two things.
We see them signing. Looks like they're signing something in there right now.
Yeah, we give them a black Sharpie to sign the White Room. It's starting a new tradition.
Hmm. Yeah, we didn't do that. That's nice.
That's awesome.
It's a good tradition.
Yeah.
And while we were in the video, we saw Bob and Doug walk down the crew access arm. Leland, it's like that, you know, futuristic look that you talked about. I mean, what did you think seeing that and how that?
You can see that duct in the hands of member number 5 there. That is an ECS duct, or environmental control system duct. Once this original, did one just, who just went in? Was that Doug or Bob?
I think that was Doug.
Okay.
Doug that
just
was Doug,
climbed
yeah.
in.
Yeah.
That is awesome.
Doug,
all right, now Bob's going in.
Yeah.
This is great. So the suit technicians are helping the crew climb inside. They're holding back the hatch seals to protect the seals on the hatch, but also making sure that the crew doesn't hit their head. To what was going in the ONC building during the suit checkouts, that seat umbilical is going to connect to the right thigh of the spacesuit. There is a fluid module that is connected to the spacesuit, and that provides fresh
control and manually flying Dragon. We can see Doug Hurley manipulating those displays right now.
And coming up, the crew will do a comm check to make sure that they can
launch pads. The weather forecast continues to be acceptable, but something we're going to watch all the way through. We're not only looking at weather at the launch site, but we are violating the conditions, or 40% chance, if you're an optimist, of good weather. But right now, the clock is continuing to count down.
In our crew notebooks, we would have names of people that were very impactful in making sure that we were perfect in our training. And
that looks like a view of Air Force One flying near Launch Pad 39A for a special guest to have a special view of the astronauts on the launch pad.
From the, we have an hour and 56 seconds away. Never mind. Instead, we are 1 hour and 45.
And right now, a lot about the crew themselves and the significance of today as the official return of human launch capability to American shores. And now we want to turn our attention to where the crew is going, the International Space Station. And for that, let's take you to Mission Control.
Good news is we've had a smooth countdown this afternoon. SpaceX team is working, no technical objections to the team. We've also just heard the call. The crew access arm retraction is underway. Great view from the camera inside the White Room as we see the arm moving away from the Dragon capsule, one of the major events necessary to get down to T0. The next one coming up will be arming of the escape system on the Dragon capsule. Now, right now, the next plan for Falcon 9, T-minus 35 minutes, we will begin loading.
Because you do have so much criteria that you have to meet. That is liquid oxygen you see venting off the rocket. That's completely normal and expected. We're standing by for a weather update.
Unless you can give us another 10 minutes, I don't think we're going to get there with any of the rules today.
I mean, give you 10 minutes.
I mean, another 10 minutes past T0.
Oh,
1645 local, I think we'll probably be clear on all the rules, but not quite going to make it for this.
Okay. We're going to check back in with you about 2 minutes, and then I'll call it up at about T-minus 17 minutes.
Okay. Yeah, some of them are starting to count down, but we still have one above 2,000. So
we now do not expect to clear in time to allow for a launch today. We go ahead and end today's launch attempt. Launch control. Go ahead and the launch auto sequence and proceed into the launch abort auto sequence, please.
Launch abort has started.
Because of weather, but as we were saying, we are looking forward to trying this again on Saturday. Our launch time on Saturday will be another instantaneous out of the way. And so we should be within just a couple of minutes for that final bit of RP-1 coming off the first stage, and then we'll hear the crew get the go to disarm that launch escape system. We'll see the crew access arm swing back in. But if you're just tuning in, Xmels tunes in also, because this is really going to be a monumental moment. We're now going to look towards Saturday for America once again launching U.S. astronauts on American rockets from American soil. With them getting out of the capsule, though, that's going to do it for us here at Hawthorne. We're going to send you back down to Florida for one last check-in with our teams there. So over to you, Marie, Lauren, Leland, if you're still sticking around, and we're going to be looking forward to Saturday.
All right, thanks a lot, Dan. Yep, we're just all sitting here. We watched Bob Behnken just climb out of his seat. Looks like he is out of Crew Dragon now, and Doug Hurley following suit, no pun intended. There we see Bob in the foreground and Doug climbing out of Crew Dragon in the background. Pad closeout team looks like helping them out, so any minute, they're going to be basically just reversing course, coming back the way. The crew's making their way back to astronaut crew quarters, where they're going to remain in quarantine until Saturday. They've been in quarantine for 2 weeks, and there they will stay to keep them safe and healthy for our next launch attempt.